Today, it's about Pattie Mallette, Justin Bieber's mom. This audience is full of believers right now, and they're all very excited. She has a new book called Nowhere But Up, the story of Justin Bieber's mom, and all of you picked up the book already. It's amazing. It's a good read. It's not just for the believers. It's for young women. It's for single mothers. It's for a whole range of people, and it's a really interesting story. So we're going to talk to her all about her story and raising Justin Bieber in just a minute. But let's get you in the mood and play Justin Bieber's latest. Here you go.
So if you love me, we could be starving. We could be homeless. We could be broke. As long as you love me, I'll be a platinum, I'll be a silver, I'll be a gold.
Justin Bieber, and here's Pattie Mallette, Justin Bieber's mom.
Hello!
You are so adorable. I was so excited to see you in person.
You are too.
we're gonna swap clothes. We're the same size. Welcome to New Music Live.
Thank you. It's good to be here. You said,
oh, the girls aren't gonna scream for me, but they are screaming and they're crying. Is this how the believers react to you all the time?
I just had a book signing the other day, and there was a lot of tears. It's great.
What's the most common thing they ask you or say to you then when they meet you?
They say, "Oh my God, thank you for making him."
Such a strange thing, but it's true. Thank you for making Justin Bieber.
You're welcome.
It's what we talk about every day. Like, that's why we have a job.
That's so funny. That's hilarious.
So you're here to talk about what you're working on, Nowhere But Up, your new book, The Story of Justin Bieber's Mom. And it is a very revealing book for people who haven't picked it up yet. Tell them what you're talking about in this book.
Yeah, it's a story of my life. And, you know, I had a really tough upbringing. It's not a, tell-all memoir. Just hopefully getting across my story and helping other people through some of their pain.
Absolutely. Now, why did you want to write this book? How long have you been working on it?
I've been working on the book itself for about a year, but I've been sharing my story for, years since Justin, before he had a career. And, I really wanted to help inspire others. And I've seen a lot of good reactions through telling my story. And I've just had a lot of people say, oh, you should write that in a book. You should write that down. And so I figured it was time.
So did it help you to write it all out? You know what I mean? And, like, you have been thinking about it and talking about it, and probably you're still dealing with some of it, but to get it out in a book, is that helpful?
Yeah, it was definitely part of my healing process, writing it down and seeing it on paper and reliving it. And it was part of it.
Mm-hmm. Well, we have, like I said, lots of believers and fans of yours and Justin's here. And actually we've got a fan who wants to talk to you and ask you a question with our host, Phoebe.
Hi.
Hi.
Crystal here. She just picked up your book today and she's already on page 78.
Hi, Crystal.
I'm going to say she's into it. She has a question for you.
My mom went through a similar situation as you. She had me when she was really young and was also mentally abused. I want to know what advice you have for us.
My advice would be to, if at all possible, get some family counseling. Counseling really helped me through, so much. And that would be, my biggest advice.
Mm-hmm. Please.
You should read the book with your mom, too.
Yeah, I want her to read it. I'll say that earlier.
Yeah, and, use it for conversation piece. Get a dialogue going.
Okay. Yeah. Thank you.
You're welcome.
So you've been on every show being able to talk about your story in the book, which is, a great promo
Amazing.
Tour. But what happens now after that? Do you want to do more work with, women like your mother and...
Yeah. I'm in the middle of starting a new foundation called Nowhere But Up. And it's going to be helping other single parent homes and, abuse victims and even financial help for counseling and things like that.
So having Justin so young, I just wonder sometimes, do you feel like his mother, or do you feel like his friend, or does it go back and forth sometimes? How do you balance that?
Well, him being 18 now, we're sort of able to be more friends now.
Yeah.
Before it was, I would tell him what he didn't want to hear and be the mom, but we've always had a close relationship, so...
I remember when I interviewed Justin a couple years ago and I asked him about you, and you're very important to him, obviously, but I remember him telling me that you would get mad at him and he'd get in trouble at that time. Can you do that still? Will he listen to you?
Yeah,
You listen here.
Yeah, you look up now. You're so tiny. So you can't ground him, can you?
I can't ground him. He doesn't live at home with me. But, you know, I'm still mom, and I have something to say. He listens.
So did you always know that this would be what happened to him? Like, did you ever fathom he would get attention for having this musical talent?
Never. You know, there's lots of talented kids, and, you know, we would just be around the house and playing musical instruments, and he was singing, and I just knew he was talented, but never imagined, you know, where he's at now. Never.
Okay, so as his mom, there's like a lot of things mothers have to deal with raising teenagers. So I want to address some of these things. Justin has gone and had a bunch of ink done, a lot of tattoos. And did he ask you for approval? Because usually you can't get them till you're 18, and he did it before. How did that all play out?
He did not ask for approval. From me.
Oh, who?
He,
Dad?
You know, he had a little bonding experience with his dad, and his dad's got tattoos. But I will say that every single one of his tattoos means something to him, and they're all, you know, they're meaningful. And that was my biggest thing. I just didn't want him to have one before he was 18 because I didn't want him to regret anything.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. You should get matching tattoos with Justin. You don't want...
I would change my mind every week, and I can't just erase a
tattoo. No, and it's permanent. Don't just get it on impulse. Now, another thing that mothers raising teenagers deal with is the whole dating thing. Did you allow him to date when this all started? I mean, before he met Selena, did you allow him to date, or were you like, were you very screening all of the girls?
You know, I talked to him all growing up and just said, you know, I'm not going to be able to stop you. I'm sure you're going to do, you know, what you're going to do when I'm not around, but I really want to encourage you to wait until you're at least 16 to date, because, you know, hopefully the purpose is to make it last and to see what could be in the future. And so I want him to take it seriously, not play with girls' hearts and you know,
well, he seems
stuff.
To be in a very steady, you know, loving relationship. What do you think of Selena Gomez?
I love her. She's a sweetheart, and what you see is what you get. She's really, really real, and really great.
Now tell me if I'm going too far here. Have you had family meetings, like, you know, her mom and the parent? You've had like group dinners together?
We've had dinners.
Yeah. So the families have met.
We all know each other.
Amazing.
There's been birthdays.
I'm just curious how your life is now. Do you spend a lot of, do you lead your own life? You're on the book tour now, but apart from this, do you lead your own life apart from Justin, or do you go on tour with him quite a lot?
No life with him. No. You know, now that he's 18, I get more time to do my own thing. Mm-hmm. And I still travel with him a little bit. He wants me to go on tour with him a bit, you know, this tour. But I'm just concentrating on this book and doing a lot of promo and this foundation and seeing where it goes.
So what's the ultimate message then you want young people to take away, women your age who might be watching? You know, there's a lot you're trying to say. And what's the key message then for this book?
I would say it does not matter what kind of pain you've been through, where you come from, where you've been, that there is hope. Even no matter how hopeless it looks, I promise there is hope.
Well, it's a very inspirational book, and everybody should check it out. Lastly, there's something you talk about in the book where you said you wouldn't date until Justin turned 18, and of course you said he's now 18. So have you gone on a date yet?
When we moved to Atlanta,
yeah,
that's when I said, you know what, I'm going to wait until you're 18 because I want to focus on all this. So he just turned 18. It's my time.
And you've been busy. So wait a sec. Does he have a huge say in who you date? Like, he has to like the guy?
I'm not sure he has a huge say in who I date, but it's important to me for him to like him, for sure. So he'll meet him at some point when I find him.
Are you against dating people in the industry?
No, I think if you meet somebody you like, it doesn't matter if they are or they're not. Yeah.
You're going to find love. I'm so happy to meet you. This has been so interesting. So everybody check out Nowhere But Up, the story of Justin Bieber's mom. And come back anytime, Pattie.
Thank you.
Okay, we love having you guys in Canada.
Thanks, guys.
Yeah.